A very warm welcome to those of you in the chapel and those of you who are joining us from your homes. It's lovely to have you with us today, and we pray that you will feel very much part of this act of worship, this prayer service here. And those of you online, you're being welcomed into the chapel with at least a good 30 of us are here tonight for this prayer service. So welcome. Helen is going to lead our worship, and our first song is Waymaker. Thank you so much, Helen. So our theme this evening, and I'm very grateful to Diane Helen doing our table this evening, it's blessing. We're going to think about blessing tonight, about how God blesses us, how we bless God, and how we are called as the people of God to be a blessing to others. And I always remember when we wrote our vision statement for our church, when years back when I was a vicar, one of the things we wanted to be was a blessing to our local community. And isn't that what we are called to be as God's beloved? To be a blessing, to draw people into the grace and the goodness and the love of God. So as we gather, a few moments quiet, and then I'm going to pray. gracious, loving God, we thank you for your presence with us now in our homes and in this chapel. We thank you that you have called us and you know us by name and you look upon us with love and you call us to be your community, to be a people open to your blessing, to be a blessing to others. So in this time of prayer, we ask you, gracious Lord, to move amongst us, renew us, refresh us, inspire us, and yes, challenge us, we pray. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to sing Bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God.
Joe is now going to come and bring our reading from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 to 17. It's from the Message version.
So, chosen by God for this new life of love, dress in the wardrobe God picked out for you. Compassion, kindness, humility, quiet strength, discipline. Be even-tempered, content with second place, quick to forgive an offense. Forgive as quickly and as completely as the Master forgave you. And, regardless of what else you put on, wear love. It's your basic all-purpose garment. Never be without it. Let the peace of Christ keep you in tune with each other, in step with each other. None of this going off and doing your own thing. And cultivate thankfulness. Let the word of Christ, the message, have the run of the house. Give it plenty of room in your lives. Instruct and direct one another using good common sense. And sing. Sing your hearts out to God. Let every detail of your lives, words, actions, whatever, be done in the name of the Master, Jesus. Thanking God the Father every step of the way.
Thank you so much, Joe. Don't you just love that passage? Isn't it just an amazing passage? It's an amazing passage in the NIV. It's a wonderful passage in the Message as well. And I love it because for me, I often use it when speaking about this is our goal to live as community. It's what we want to be as we live as community. And it's challenging, isn't it? It's a challenging passage. I wonder, what are the things that you say most? What's your currency that comes out of your mouth? What are the things that you speak most about? There was a parish priest who went to a university as a visiting lecturer. And he reported back to a friend that the main currency that was being shared with people to one another was grievance. That was the main sort of currency, the things that people were speaking to one another. I often think about here at Scargill, what is the currency that we are sharing with one another? And it may be worth thinking, what is my own personal currency? What's the thing that comes out of my mouth a lot, or your mouth a lot? The passage from Colossians challenges us to have a currency that is based on God's love for us and his calling upon our lives. It starts off by saying, so chosen by God. And I love that, the fact that each one of us are chosen by God, called his beloved. And the words and currency that God says to us, he says, you are my child, with whom I love, with whom I am well pleased. That's the currency of God to us. And that's the currency that God wants us to share with one another that comes out of that beautiful passage from Colossians. Henry Nouwen speaks about how we need to bless. And to bless, he says, is to say good things. He says this, we have to bless one another constantly. Parents need to bless their children, children their parents, husbands their wives, wives their husbands, friends their friends. In our society so full of curses, we must fill each place we enter with our blessings. We forget so quickly that we are God's beloved children and allow the many curses of our world to darken our hearts. Therefore, we have to be reminded of our belovedness and remind others of theirs. Whether the blessing is given in words or with gestures, in a solemn or informal way, our lives need to be blessed lives. Isn't that a wonderful calling that we are called, is to bless one another? To give a blessing is to say yes to a person's belovedness, their chosenness by God. And it's interesting that the word, the Hebrew word for bless, actually has in it the sense that we kneel as we give a blessing. There's a bowing down when we bless. It's not a place of power or strength, not in ourselves. It's actually when we give a blessing, we do it vulnerably and on our knees. Isn't it amazing that Jesus, when he blessed his disciples, and I think of the blessing of the disciples when he washed their feet, he did it on his knees, called to bless. It is the most significant affirmation we can offer one another. And it's difficult. Here at Scargill, we have a rule of life, a rhythm of life that we follow. And in our promises, it says this. Jesus had no hidden agenda. He never gossiped nor betrayed anyone. He supported and encouraged the truth, even when people didn't want to hear it. And it goes on to say, will you say nothing about another person that could not be said to them personally if love and wisdom required it? Ouch. Ouch. But when we can, with God's help, take that promise on, then we can begin to see that we are blessing others and that we're growing in love for one another. To be a blessing for one another, and for people to be blessed as they come into our homes, into our lives, into our churches, even here at Scargill. Called to bless, because we have received so much blessing. Let's just think about that for a moment. And then Helen's going to lead us in a song, a familiar tune to some of you. It was a new tune for Helen today, with new words. Sisters and brothers with one voice. So we come to our prayers, and we're going to use that song that we had earlier on, "Bless the Lord, there is no other God," in between each prayer. So let us pray. Come, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and enliven our lives with your transforming presence. Inspire us to be a blessing to those around us, sharing your self-giving, joyful love, to speak affirmation and truth, encouragement. Inspire the churches we represent and the Scargill community here to be a place of blessing, to generously give away your love, where lives are shared and lives are transformed. Bless the Lord, there is no other God.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God. Bless the Lord.
Come, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and bring your loving order in your world where there is so much chaos. You are a God of relationship and communion. Gracious God, where there is dominion, injustice, and war, come with your transforming love. And in the quiet, we lift those places we know where God is healing, peace is needed, particularly the Ukraine and Afghanistan, but other places that are on your hearts. Bless, inspire, encourage, and strengthen those working for peace and justice. Bless the Lord, there is no other God.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God.
Come, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and bless those who are struggling today. Come, bless and strengthen refugees seeking sanctuary. Come, bless and bring healing to those who are struggling with ill health, physical, and those struggling with mental health, particularly young people. Come, bless and relieve those who are struggling with the increased financial pressures of paying the bills and providing food for their families. Come, bless those who we find difficult, those people we don't get on with, and those that we have unresolved conflict with. Come, bless those we love dearly, our families and friends. Bless the Lord, there's no other God.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God.
Julian of Norwich wrote, "We are enfolded in the Father, and we are enfolded in the Son, and we are enfolded in the Spirit. Our souls rest in God, its true peace. Our soul stands in God, its true strength, and is deeply rooted in God for endless love. Come, Holy Trinity, and open our hearts and lives to receive your abundant love." Bless the Lord, there is no other God.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, there is no other God.
I'm going to ask Helen now to come and read one of her poems, a wonderful poem of blessing.
This is called Bless the Lord for Blackberries, and it's written as a prayer of thanks. Bless the Lord for blackberries, and bless the Lord for sloes, for hazelnuts and elderflowers and everything that grows. Bless the Lord for bonfires and their autumn smoky smell, for friends sharing marshmallows and the stories that we tell. Bless the Lord for woodlands, a peaceful place to be, for hedgehogs, deer and buzzards and every kind of tree. Bless the Lord for sledging and the fun of snowball fights. Bless the Lord for countless stars on cold and cloudless nights. Bless the Lord for tawny owls calling in the night, and bless him for rare glimpses of their graceful silent flight. Bless the Lord for lapwings, for the way they dive and sing, and bless the Lord for curlews, hopeful heralds of the spring. Bless the Lord for house martins that spend the summer here, and cheeky, faithful robins that stay with us all year. Bless the Lord for greenhouses, warm air and buzzing bees, nasturtiums and tomato vines, and especially sweet peas. Bless the Lord for clear blue skies and endless hills to climb, for squashed cheese sandwich picnics and the warmth of summertime. Bless the Lord for cups of tea and lazy days in bed, for the simple task of kneading dough and the smell of fresh baked bread. Amen.
Thank you, Helen. And not to make you feel at all jealous of the at home, but we had fresh bread for lunch today, and I have to say it was lovely. So notices, if there's anything that we can pray for you here as a community, please do send it through to us, prayer@scargillmovement.org. It'll be our joy to pray for you. And just to say that next week, there will be no Wednesday service next week. So we'll be definitely here the week after, but we won't be here next week. So a blessing from the Franciscan tradition. May God bless you with discomfort at easy answers, half-truths, and superficial relationships, so that you may live deep within your heart. May God bless you with anger at injustice, oppression, and exploitation of people, so that you may work for justice, freedom, and peace. May God bless you with tears to shed for those who suffer from pain, rejection, and starvation, and war, so that you may reach out your hand to comfort them and turn their pain to joy. And may God bless you with enough foolishness to believe that you can make a difference in this world, so that you can do what others claim cannot be done. Amen. And so Helen's going to play another song, a familiar tune to different words, Let Love Be Real.
Without the need. May he bring